गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, दिस इज योर साइंस क्लास एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट द स्केलेटल सिस्टम विच इज योर सेकेंड चैप्टर. नाउ यू सी इन दिस पिक्चर देयर आर सम बोनी स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ डिफरेंट एनिमल्स एज वेल एज ह्यूमन. So in this chapter we will learn about the skeletal system, joints, muscles, and how we can care these muscles and different joints. So let us start. First, look at yourself in the mirror. Feel your head, cheeks, jaw and shoulders. Can you feel some hard structures in all these parts? These hard structures are called bones. Now imagine if the bones you felt were not there. How would your looks change? Second, would your body be firm and stiff, or would it be just soft like a jelly? The bones give shape and support to our body. So when you touch your body, you can feel under the skin some hardness. That hard structure is called bones. So now in this chapter the first topic is human skeletal system. The bone in the human body make up the skeleton. It provides a framework for the body. The skeletal system consists of the skull, the backbone, the rib cage, and two pairs of limbs. Two pairs means four. So four limbs, or you can say arms. We have two arms, left arm and right arm, and hind limbs, that means legs. We have one pair of leg, that means two legs, left leg and right leg, and the girdles. These are the parts of skeletal system. What? The skull, the backbone, the rib cage, the two pairs of limbs and girdle. Now let us study one by one. So before study the skull, we learn about the bones. As you see in this picture, this is the human skeletal system. The adult human skeleton consists of 206 bones. A bone looks hard and smooth on the outside, but the inside of a bone is very soft due to the presence of a blood forming substance called bone marrow. Bone marrow is very important because it is known as blood forming substance. So bone marrow produces blood cell. As you see in this picture, this is a picture of inside a bone. This is the soft part of a bone, and these blue and red color lines are vessels through which blood flow into the bone, and these are the outsider part of bone, which is very hard. And inside bone, a hollow space in which semi-solid liquid, or you can say that semi-solid substance, are filled up. These are called bone marrow. So in our skeletal system, the first part, that means the skull, the human skull is made up of 22 bones fused together. Fused means after mixing. The human skull is made up of 22 bones fused together. There are 8 bones arranged like a jigsaw that covers and protects the brain. The facial region contains 14 bones, among which only the lower jaw is movable. This part enables to us to talk and eat. As you see, this is the picture of a skull, and this is the facial part, and this one is the lower part. So this human skull is made up of 22 bones, and these 22 bones are mixed up together and make a skull. And here, this is the facial part. In that region, there are 14 bones. Here, there are 14 bones. And here, along this part, there are 8 bones arranged. So 14 and the 8, that means 22 bones. And this part, this is the lower part, and you can say lower jaw. Only this part is movable, and when we talk something and when we eat something, then only this part move, and all these are fixed. So this is the skull. Now the second part of our skeletal system is the backbone. As you see in this picture, this is the picture of backbone. The backbone or a spine is the main axis of a skeleton. As you see in your backside, you see a long bone, which is backbone. It helps us to twist and bend and holds the body upright. It contains 33 small bones called vertebra. As you see in this picture, there are so many small bones, and these are 33 in numbers. These small bones called vertebra, and these are connected one by one to each other and form a vertebral column. This one a small bone is called vertebra, and all these vertebra connected to each other and make a long, just like pipe. This is called vertebral column. The vertebral column protect the spinal cord, which is a large bundle of nerves that send information from the brain to the rest of the body and back. In between this vertebral column, here there are so many nerves passes through this column and connected to the different part of the body, and here these nerves are connected to the our brain. So these nerves are called a spinal cord, and through this spinal cord information are communicated between the body parts and the brain. So our backbone is very important. Because now the third part of a skeletal system is the rib cage. As you see here, this is the picture of rib cage. There are 12 pairs of the curved bone, like chest region. This bone-like structure are present in our chest. So these bone are called ribs. These are the ribs. There are 12 pairs. That means 24. They form a cage-like structure. As you see here, this is just like a cage. So this form with rib and like cage. So finally, this is called rib cage. The rib cage enclose the two vital organs of our body, the heart and the lungs. Actually, rib cage is the important for the protection of lungs and heart, because inside the rib cage, heart and lungs are present. So rib cage is important for the protection of heart and lungs. The ribs are joined to the backbone at the back and a long bone at the center of the chest called the breastbone or a sternum in front. As you see, this is the front part. This is the front part and called breastbone. And in back side, the backbone. So the lowest two pair of ribs are joined only the backbone, lowest two part here, these two, first and the first. This is the back part of rib cage and this is the front part of rib cage. This is called, this one is called a sternum, or you can say that breastbone. And this is backbone. Now these two, only these two, are the lower pair of ribs which only joined with backbone, and that's why these are called floating ribs. Now the fourth part of our skeletal system is limbs. The four limbs or arms stretch from the soldier to the finger tips. As you see here, this is the soldier, and from this part to the this part, this is the fingertip. So from this to this called four limbs. So we have two arms, left and right, but their structure are the same. So let us start. It is joined to the spine through the soldier girdle. The bones of arms consist of a long upper arm bone, which is called humerus. This is the upper long arm bone, which is called humerus. Two lower arm, this one, two lower arm bones, and a large number of small bones that make up the wrist, hand and finger. This. There are so many bones which are connected together and form a structure which are finger. Now the second limb is hind limbs. That means leg. You can see here, this is the hind limbs. The hind limbs or leg are large and strong. They help to support the body weight. The bones of the leg consist of hip girdle, femur, kneecap, lower leg bones, and foot bone. So, a long thigh bone called the femur. This is the longest bone in our body. Two lower leg bones. This one, two lower leg bones. A circular bone called knee cap. This is knee cap, which protect the knee, and a number of small bones that make up the ankle, foot, and toes. These are the foot bones. So, the next fifth part of our skeletal system is girdles. The ring-like bones that make up the shoulder and hip are called girdle. In the our shoulder, there is a girdle, so shoulder girdle, and this is the hip girdle. As you see in a full picture here, this is the shoulder girdle, and this one is the hip girdle. This is very important for the movement of whole leg, or here this is important for the movement of shoulder. So let us start. The ring-like bones that make up the shoulder and hip are called girdles. These are the shoulder girdles and the hip girdle. The shoulder blade and the collar bone make up the shoulder girdle. This is the collar bone and shoulder blade. These two make a shoulder girdle. The hip girdle consists of three bones fused together. So these are the parts of skeletal system: the skull, the backbone, the rib cage, the limbs, and girdles. Now, the function of now in next video we will discuss about the joints. So for today it is enough, and your homework is write the parts of our skeletal system and what are the functions of a skeletal system. There are two questions for your homework. First, write down the parts of human skeletal system, and the second is what are the function of the skeletal system. So these two questions are your homework. So for today, this is enough. Thanks.